Okay, nobody likes getting sick, right? Especially right now with global pandemic numbers on the rise again. It's critical to keep our immune systems right on track, keep them healthy. And a lot of times people don't think about the health of their immune system until we finally feel something coming on. We feel a cold or a virus or a strep throat, and suddenly we're at the pharmacy or the natural food store and we're stocking up on all the things, all the home remedy tricks and everything we learned from our grandmothers, right? However, as I always say, a good offense is the best defense. And the best way to fight illness, no matter what it is to prevent it in the first place. And you can do that by just taking a few simple steps each and every day to improve your immune system. Welcome. If this is your first time tuning in, I'm Audrey Christie. I'm a functional integrative nurse, nutritionist, and energy medicine practitioner. I help women stop chasing symptoms, find relief, and ultimately heal their bodies from autoimmune disease. I hear all the time, "I tried X remedy and it didn't work. I tried vitamin C for my cold and it didn't work." Most often that happens because you waited too late to try it. Waiting too late happens when we're not in touch with our human suits, we're not in touch with the signs and signals that our body's giving us, so we don't know when something is amiss, when something's coming on, and then we end up waiting too long and now we're trying to play defense, and that's not a good strategy. So instead of scouring Amazon, standing in line at your local pharmacy or health food store when you get sick, trying to find all the remedies to help, maybe, just maybe, with this video, I can convince you to try just a tiny bit of offense, right? We're going to talk about some simple steps you can do each day. These are good for the whole family, good for people with autoimmune disease, especially people with autoimmune disease, that will help you so much more than cramming vitamin C or herbal tea when you've already come down with something. So here's the first thing: get enough sleep. And you can find this information in episode 116 and 117. I will link to that. But getting enough quality sleep each and every night is essential for a healthy immune system. Try to get the recommended 7 to 8 hours sound sleep, head on the pillow, quality time. And it can take a little bit of practice to build that up, but studies have shown us over and over and over again that a lack of sleep significantly weakens your immune system. So if you have trouble falling asleep, set up a good nightly routine. That's going to be found in episode 116. And if that doesn't work and you need a little help, check out episode 117 for the plant medicine to do that with. Biggest thing that I have to tell people and remind people over and over and over again is put your screens away at least 1 hour before bed. And if for some reason you have to work a little late, closer to bedtime or at night, get yourself some blue light protecting glasses. Number two, eat your antioxidants. Our bodies need the right fuel to fight off infections. There's no way around it. There's no pill potion or supplement that will fix it. Antioxidants clear out free radicals from the body, which otherwise would cause inflammation and immune system confusion and stress, right? So particularly, we're looking at vitamin A, C, and E, very rich antioxidants to help regulate that immune response. So make sure you're eating your vegetables and your fruits to get these essential micronutrients. And if you can't get enough of these in your diet, try again. Think of creative ways, smoothies and salads and shakes instead of. Now, you can supplement, you can add a regular high-quality multivitamin, but it's not gonna fix it. You can't out-supplement a bad diet, period. And anyone who tells you that you can is probably trying to sell you something. The next one, number three, is to stop stressing. Stress not only affects your mental well-being, but it also takes enormous tolls on your physical health. So acute stress can be sometimes useful, right? For those short bursts of adrenaline that might be needed. But most of us aren't dealing with acute bursts of stress. We're dealing with chronic and lasting stress. This wreaks havoc on your body. It can lead to adrenal fatigue, chronic low-grade inflammation, which all leads you to a weakened immune system. I have full episodes on how to stop stressing, lots of them. Episode 118 and 094. Again, I will link to those. If you're feeling stressed out, try to get to the root of the problem causing the stress and fix that. Just like with your health, your ultimate solution lies in the roots. Making sure on a day-to-day basis also that you take some time to relax and unwind after a stressful day so that your body can recover. Number four, exercise, but, and it's a big but, not too intensely. Yes, exercise is critical for your overall health. It specifically benefits the immune system by helping to circulate your immune cells throughout the body. It also lowers inflammation, reduces stress levels, all big benefits, all key for a robust immune system. However, if you are overly exercising or intensely exercising too much, they found about 150 minutes for a week is about what you need to just kind of be right there. But if you're exercising too intensely, either in duration or in exertion, so the amount of effort that you're having to put in, then you can have adverse effects on your immune system. Same goes for if you're not having enough recovery time. So if you're just beating yourself, exercising, pounding the pavement, lifting those weights day after day after day. So exercise smart, not harder. So walking, yoga, definitely doing weights. An intensity level is different for everyone, right? Make sure you give your body enough time to recover. And exercising for hours each day is not helping your body. The next one is practice good hygiene. It is essential to have a strong immune system to fight off infections, but for all those other things, you want to wash your hands, right? Practice good hygiene. Avoid touching your face, which I've done a bunch of times during this video because I have one little hair that doesn't want to get off my nose. But you want to wash your hands frequently, but not too frequently, okay? If you wash your hands too frequently, too strong of cleaner, you actually take off your body's ability to fight infections itself. You can't sterilize your hands, so you might as well stop trying. So use hand sanitizer, use soap, non-toxic hand sanitizer, use soap as needed, but you don't have to sanitize after you touch every little thing. Make sure you're still getting out, getting your hands dirty in the earth and the soil rather than getting your hands dirty at the store. Social distancing is the next one. So much fun, right? Social distancing. Here's the thing, friends. It is not new science that if person A is sick and person B doesn't go near them, person B won't get sick, okay? That's not rocket science at all. It's absolutely correct. So practice social distancing, avoid big crowds, especially if you or somebody you care for is at high risk to catch any disease, right? The next thing is masks. So if you don't follow me on social media, I'm going to talk about these more in individual posts. Definitely check out Facebook and Instagram for that. So I will be showing on Instagram how to utilize a face mask properly, right? Because I see a lot of improper face masking happening, right? And when to use one. So I'll tell you now when to use one. Using one indoors when you're around a bunch of strangers, probably a good idea. Using one outdoors when you're running on the trail or out jogging or cycling or walking isn't helping you and it isn't helping anyone else. So leave that off. Allow your body to oxygenate. That's better for your immune system anyways. A lot of times I see people hanging their masks in the windshield or on their car window. And somewhere along the line on our precious social media, somebody said that hanging the mask allows the UV rays to hit it and sterilizes the mask, effectively reprocessing, making it good for reuse. That's kind of a half truth. Yes, UVC rays will kill COVID on a face mask. The only way you can get UVC rays is not through a glass window. So you can't get it through a glass home window, right? So hanging it in your home window is not going to work. Your car window blocks UVA, UVB, and UVC. So if you live somewhere where it's hot, then chances are you're killing it anyways because your car is like a little oven. Like here in North Texas, our cars routinely get well over 120, 150 degrees on the inside. So if that's you, you're probably doing a good job anyways. But just hanging it in your windshield and expecting the sun to kill whatever is on the outside of it is not going to work. You have to use different solutions, different strategies for that. So these are crazy times we live in, yeah? And it's always been important to have a strong immune system, always, so that you can have your best expression of wellness. I definitely recommend that people with autoimmune disease take extra precautions because you are at a higher risk for catching anything up into including this global pandemic virus. So right now, taking care of your immune system is super, super critical, but it always has been, okay? I created a free resource for you, 5 steps you can start today to begin healing from your autoimmune disease. It has specifically simple steps you can take right now, including mindset, nutrition, to help shift you from a healing path to a healing path from the path you're on now. You can download that at audreychristie.com/autoimmune. To wrap this up, this is an interesting time we are living in, and boosting your immune system is at the top of everyone's priority list, but it should have been there all along. So along with these daily tasks, eating as many plants as possible will give you the strong immune system that you need. Loading up on vegetables, drinking copious amounts of fresh water, and lessening your load of environmental toxins by kicking them out of your house. I have a free class on that. I'll link that below too. So make time for things that nourish your body, nourish your relationships, and make you feel connected. There are so many things that come together to help create that robust immune system that you need. Thank you so much for tuning in. It would mean the world to me if you would take a second to leave a comment and hit the like button. I hope you have the most magical and restful day, and I challenge you to leave this world just a little bit better than how you found it when you woke up this morning. Be well.